Good afternoon, Jets Nation. Welcome to the Jew Jets Show. And Mecole Hardman is back to being a Kansas City Chief. Let's talk about it. So this offseason, we signed Mecole Hardman to a one-year deal. We were planning to use him more as a wide receiver, utilize his speed, put him back to the return game, that sort of thing. Robert Saleh was hyping up this Mecole Hardman signing. I was excited to see Mecole Hardman on Hard Knocks, was thinking this dude was finna ball out for the New York Jets this year. But then it comes week one, he gets one offensive play snap. Week two, week three, week four, week five, week six come along, and he continues to barely see the field. And obviously, it just made the most sense to trade him. And that's what the New York Jets did. And it was just puzzling that the Jets never found a role for Mecole Hardman in the offense after we wanted him in free agency, after he wanted to come here, that sort of thing. We just couldn't find a role for him. And it's always interesting when stuff like that happens. But also at the same time, I think we had a role for him envisioned. It's just Xavier Gipson took his job. I mean, the guy that's been returning kicks, the guy that's been used as a gadget player has been Xavier Gipson. And that's primarily what Mecole Hardman has done in the NFL throughout his first 4 years. So basically, Mecole Hardman got his job taken by undrafted free agent Xavier Gipson, and that's why he never saw the field. So at least the Jets did the right thing by trading him back to the Kansas City Chiefs. I mean, just trading him regardless, or even releasing him, would have been the right thing to do, just so he can continue to play in the NFL, continue to put work on the field, because this dude is on a one-year deal. He doesn't have a team guaranteed for next season. So for him to just get back on the field, play, prove to other teams that he's worthy of signing to a long-term deal, that was just the right thing to do from the New York Jets, and glad we did that. And at least we traded him as well, because I'm just happy we got something from Mecole Hardman. Some people might not be happy with getting a 2025 sixth round pick, but it's better than nothing. Also, along with Mecole Hardman, the Kansas City Chiefs also get our 2025 seventh round pick. But what does the Mecole Hardman trade mean for the New York Jets? And personally, I don't really think it means anything. I mean, we already have six wide receivers on our roster, which is a lot more than any other NFL team has. Normally, teams keep five receivers on the roster. We have six. So we're already plus sized in that category to begin with. And Mecole Hardman also didn't play for the New York Jets. I mean, it's point blank simple. We didn't put Mecole Hardman on the field. So in terms of what trading him away means, not really anything, because we didn't use Mecole Hardman at all. If the Jets make a move for a wide receiver, I don't think it's going to be because of Mecole Hardman. It's because we need another playmaker in that group. Because when Garrett Wilson missed a couple snaps due to a minor injury suffered in Sunday's game against the Philadelphia Eagles, the passing game looked absolutely weak. They couldn't get anything going. And outside of Alan Lazard, we really don't have any other weapons in the receiving game. Randall Cobb has been a complete pile of trash this year. Xavier Gipson's still an undrafted free agent that needs to work a bit more on his route running and whatnot. I mean, there's a reason why this dude was an undrafted free agent, and maybe he can develop more into a good player as the season goes along, but as of right now, he's not at that level, and the trade deadline's approaching very fast. So I definitely think the Jets should make a move for a wide receiver, just because we need another playmaker in this offense. As to who that wide receiver should be, there's a pretty long list of guys that we could potentially, you know, have the option to trade for. Zach Rosenblatt of The Athletic mentioned these five guys: Rashad Bateman from the Ravens, Darnell Mooney from the Bears, Terrence Marshall Jr. from the Panthers, and Cortland Sutton and Jerry Jeudy from the Broncos. Now, the most realistic out of all of those five guys, I think, is Jerry Jeudy. He also didn't mention Hunter Renfro, which I think is interesting because he's also been a name that's been constantly thrown in that trade discussion. And I think it's pretty realistic that Hunter Renfro gets traded away as well. But the rest of those receivers, I really don't envision getting moved at the deadline this year. I could also see Terrence Marshall getting traded, but he wouldn't really do much for this Jets offense to begin with anyway. So Jerry Jeudy, Hunter Renfrow, two guys that I really want the New York Jets to trade for and really think could actually happen. Those two guys definitely would add an extra element to this offense, add an extra weapon in the passing game that the Jets desperately need. Also, I would call in on Corey Davis, see if he's interested in making an NFL comeback. I know he's only been retired for, what, 7 weeks now? 8 weeks, something like that. But still, just calling him, see if he's interested in making an NFL return. Doesn't hurt to check, because we could definitely use Corey Davis about right now. But Mecole Hardman's no longer a New York Jet. Maybe we make a move for a wide receiver at the trade deadline. Let me guys know what your thoughts on all this is down below in the comment section. But I'm your host, Jet, signing off for now. See you guys later. Peace.